Hey gents, one of my favorite things to cover on this channel are like cutting edge things. Most guys out there don't know that there are performance dress shirts, but you sure do, and that's why you're watching this video. You might not even have noticed that this is actually a performance dress shirt. This is Mizzen & Main's blue label. You can tell by their signature blue stitch and the button, which is even hidden by the tie. So what I wanna cover today is the problem I have called dress shirts. I grabbed one of each from every brand. I've been wearing these collectively for the past 2+ years. So I've tried every brand that I can find, and I've also put them through their paces, traveling, office, daily wear, everything in between, washing, drying, all of that. And so I'll put this all down in video today, give you my thoughts, but as with my sneaker roundup, this is gonna be a moment in time, and I'll have a guide on my website that will be continuously updated because these shirts get updated, new brands can be added, and so this is just a jumping off point for you, but it's the best that I can do after delaying this video for several months as I've been trying to get more time with each of the brands. First, we'll start off with why even choose to go with a performance dress shirt. The highlights of a performance dress shirt are that they are much more comfortable than a traditional cotton shirt. They last longer over time. You don't have to care for them in the same way. You can actually just machine wash these and then not worry about the dry cleaner like other shirts, which also helps to extend the life. They will be moisture wicking, which helps with your daily comfort, cooling tech. They're also the best shirts to travel with, whether you're wearing them on the flight or you pack them, because they are so wrinkle resistant and crease resistant. And I find that they tend to be more stain resistant than cotton, especially because you can just wash them. So if you get some ketchup on it, it'll come off. And shirts like the Threadsmith shirt are completely hydrophobic, which is really cool. And all of the care for these shirts is extremely similar. You just wash it on cold or warm water and you hang dry it. That's all you have to do, and they come out perfect every time. First, what I'll do today is go over a couple of categories and recommendations within there based on the best shirt, the best fit, that sort of thing. And then we'll talk about each brand individually because there's 11 brands here, and I'm just gonna go right down them alphabetically from Bluffworks to Woody's. So your next question might be, who needs them? Well, it's anybody that travels frequently, anybody that wants longer shirts, so buying less shirts, which ones that last longer. Anyone who's looking for a more comfortable dress shirt, this is especially the case with hot or humid climates. I will talk about some of the guys in Texas I hear from that won't go back to anything but Mizzen & Main. And also for athletic builds, if you're used to gym clothing and workout, like Nike dry fit stuff, these shirts are made of very similar fabric, and so it is more comfortable, but they're also cut in ways that is typically better for guys who work out. The last thing before get in is you don't need an undershirt with any of these because it kind of defeats the purpose of having this soft, very cooling type of shirt. And so I don't typically wear undershirts with my regular dress shirts, but with these, it's even more the case. I also put links below to all the brands. If there's any sort of discounts, those will be in there as well. Using the links lets them know you came from me, keeps more videos like this coming. Also, this video has no sponsors or anything like that. This is me buying a bunch of shirts, trying to give you the best information. Subscribe, like, all that stuff. Now let's get into the best of the best. So after spending hundreds of hours with all these performance shirts, I can say the best shirt that you can go into this category is going to be Mizzen & Main. For a few reasons. Number one, they are the softest, stretchiest of all the shirts. They offer the widest range of style, color combinations, as well as sizes. So you can go with dress or casual. You can also go with the Leeward or Spinnaker. All the stuff I'll talk about today are the Leeward shirts. Those are my preferred line in there, but they also have some of the best. You can go from white dress shirt for your wedding up to a casual shirt, which I'll drop in here. They run from small to double XL, and then also they have a trim tall and standard fits. So they have the most selection there, and they are the category leader. They largely invented this category in itself, and they're one of the few shirts in my entire wardrobe that are made in the USA, and so all around, I believe this is the best company you can go with. They have a polyester spandex blend. This isn't like your JCPenney cheap shirt polyester. It's a very soft, very breathable polyester, but if you don't like that, you would go to number two, and that's where you're gonna start to integrate some of the cotton selections of this roundup, and so your number two selections are either gonna be Bonobos or Woody's, and they both have their strengths, and we'll talk about each of them. So Bonobos has way more fit options, way more style options, and Woody's offers a fully custom fit, which you can customize the options of the shirt down to the collar size, the cuff size, the placket, and your neck, everything. You can customize the full shirt, and this is one of my favorite performance fabrics that I've tried out. This category, your number two category, also comes into the best fit. So the best fit out of all the shirts is going to be from Woody's, because it's custom. Bonobos, they have tons of sizes. The other place to go if you're looking for best fit is going to be Stant, but I'm not as crazy about the fabric in that one. Or you can go with Deo Veritas, which I'll talk about in my bamboo shirt. Your lowest price option is going to be Twillery. You can get four of these shirts for $54 each, which is the best. However, I'm not crazy about the fabric. I think this is an incredible shirt for the price, but this is not going to compare directly to someone like Mizzen Main or Bonobos. That's the Bonobos dress shredder, if I didn't mention that, by the way. And then I originally had a category for most like a dress shirt, but basically all of these shirts are extremely similar to a standard dress shirt. Bonobos is indistinguishable. Woody's, no one ever noticed when I wore this to a CEO meeting. Ministry Supply has the most technical fabric, and I really like this shirt. I actually ran a half marathon wearing a Ministry Supply shirt, and the best part of that, talking about the feature of the shirt, is you just put it in the washing machine and it's done. You throw it in the wash, it's clean, laundered, all good, not a big problem there. Ministry Supply. State and Liberty is really the only two shirts that I couldn't come to a great recommendation for any specific reason was State and Liberty or Stant. State and Liberty seems to be just trying to do what Mizzen and Main is doing, except making it in China and saving $25 or $30. The fabric is of a lower grade. It's not as soft, it's not as stretchy, and they differentiate themselves by having fits for muscular guys, but you can achieve the same fit and even better in Mizzen and Main because you can choose your small, medium, large, and you can choose the trim options. State and Liberty is just basically small through double XL. And Bluffworks is also one where, you know, the prices are $125. It looks like they're about to refresh the line because there's only three styles on there, but I wasn't crazy about the fabric. It actually had more of a smell retention like typical cotton shirts did in the other ones. And then Stant is like, okay, it's cool they have so many sizes, but if you want the size options, Bonobos and Woody's has a better fabric and also more selection of colors and options. So those are all the shirts, and I'll just talk about a little bit more detail for each of them, but I'm kind of getting ahead of myself here. Let's go through each of the brands individually and talk about their size, colors, prices, and various options individually. So start with Bluffworks. This is the Heritage Meridian. It comes in at 125. It's a 98 poly, 2% spandex blend. The size options on this are really great. They have small, medium, large, and you can also just choose tall. You're seeing me in the small tall here. It has a very sturdy collar with collar stays. The style options are extremely limited. It's made in China, and the fabric does feel slightly stiff. It's not nearly as stretchy as some of the other ones. And what's unfortunate about Bluffworks shirt is that one of my favorite features of their blazer is that they make it right in New York City, but the shirts are made in China. So I hope that maybe the new line would be made in the USA as well as the blazer is. And I found that the material was holding a little bit more like body smell than the rest of the shirts. Bonobos is one of my favorite shirts in this entire roundup. It's extremely soft. They have tons of color options. They have tons of size options. This is the Jet Setter. This is $128. They also offer a Swiss cotton option, which I have Swiss cotton underwear and it is luxurious. So I'm really curious to check those out, but this is the Jet Setter. This is a 76% cotton, 21% nylon, 3% spandex blend. Like I said, with the size options, this is a 15.5-35 tailored slim. And this is one of the few brands that also offers extended sizes. You'll probably get that with a custom, but not with the others. This has one of the best collars in the roundup. I gave them a 5 out of 5 for style options. It's made in Malaysia. It's super soft. And there's some sort of like designer magic within Bonobos where when I wear the shirts, I get a lot of compliments. So I'm a fan of the styles that they offer, and this one has been great. Now, Deo Veritas is a unique one. This is a custom one. So it's 100% bamboo. You can see I've been wearing it quite a bit. I also got the monogram. And the key here is that you can customize your collar style, your cuff style. These come in at 120, so it's right within the price range of the others. The fact that you can get the custom fit is perfect, as you can see in my shirt here. And you'll also notice on some of the custom shirts, the length can vary. So this is the perfect length on me because it helps me to keep these things tucked in. I also find that this has one of the best anti-wrinkle out of all the shirts in the roundup. I also like that you can get some of the more premium options that aren't available on the other shirts with this, so you can get Mueller Pro buttons. So there's some great stuff from Deo Veritas. Next, we have a Ministry of Supply, and this is the shirt that markets itself as having NASA-grade engineering in the shirt, and I really like this shirt. It comes in at 115. It's a 98 poly, 2% elastane. This also has better sizing options, so I have a medium, slim, and this one. It has integrated collar stays. It's made in China, and I love the fabric and design on here. I've actually had almost all of the Ministry of Supply shirts going back several years, so I had the Arrow, I had, they used to call it the Day Starter and other ones. And in my experience, this is one of the coolest running dress shirts. Their big thing is all about this very technical fabric. And so while it's not the stretchiest, it is some of the better looking shirts. And they also have some of the best cooling tech to really wick moisture and keep you cool all day. Mizzen & Main is one of my most recommended brands overall on the channel for all the reasons I talked about before. Tons of styles, tons of options, fits are really easy to get. I also have their pants, which I really like, and I have some of their Henleys. You have the signature blue stitching on the button here. You also have the option to go with their standard leeward or their blue label if you want to pay the premium. The blue label allows you to do the French style cuffs. It also has a full placket on here, so it's a slightly better shirt. It's more of a traditional dress shirt versus the standard leeward, but I do find the spinnaker to be very comfortable, but it's not that close to a regular dress shirt, which is why I think you're seeing their line kind of go toward the leewards overall. Also, the only dress shirt in all of here that is made in the USA. They also do a lot of outreach to veterans organizations and work with them. They also are the one brand that, as I recommend them, I hear tons of great feedback from, where guys come back and say they'll never use anything else. And so overall, Mizzen & May, my favorite in the roundup. Twillery is the real darling of this because it is the lowest cost. So if you want to get into performance dress shirts, sort of experience what it's like to not have to worry about dry cleaning, and you're able to just wash it on warm with all the other stuff. It does have some really nice comfort features, like your cuffs have this really nice like cloth lining on the inside. Same thing with the top back of here. But I think it is, the fabric is a little bit too thin. Like if you don't wear a dress shirt underneath, it's like kind of odd. And so I think these are a good entry point into here. However, Twillery remains one of my favorite recommendations for standard dress shirts. So their standard safe cotton dress shirts are still some of my favorite that you can buy. And so what I would do is buy like two of those, depending on your budget. I would buy like one or two of those and then just pick a performance dress shirt so you can see what it's like, because I do like these for the price. But if I'm gonna buy a performance dress shirt, I'm gonna go into the next tier. Stant, I have covered on the channel before. I got one of their white dress shirts way back, and I found out that my data fit size is the Mercer, and it's an okay fabric. I got this a little bit early. I was able to buy it as our Kickstarter was still running, so I was able to put it through its paces. It's not very stretchy. It is a 91 nylon, 9% spandex blend. It has removable collar stays. It's made in Honduras, but they don't offer like a plain white. So when I was trying to gauge style options, I was looking at, do they offer a white shirt so you can get that for the office and then some like nice styles in there. And so I think that might be coming more, you know, it comes down to, you know, Mizzen & May is built on being a performance dress shirt brand. Some of these others like Bonobos or Stant, they're a dress shirt brand that also does performance. And so that's why I think you're not seeing pretty good shirts versus someone like Mizzen & May, which is built on this concept. Next we have State & Liberty, and like I mentioned, these have a thinner fabric than the Bonobos. It is a 92 polyester 8% spandex blend. They only have small through double XL sizes, and so you can't get those kind of trim options. They do market themselves as having fits for athletic guys. I think you can get that with other brands. So even though these come in at $90, you can tell they're cutting the corners just enough to get below Mizzen & Main's prices, but without really offering something that's very differentiated. And so State & Liberty, I do have to say, the thing I really like is their collar design. They have this button collar design here, which helps it stay up underneath like a blazer. And so that's like the only thing that I would take from this for the other shirts. But State & Liberty has just been okay. Threadsmiths is the other one in this roundup that's pretty easy to go past quickly. It is 100% cotton. I included it because it's hydrophobic, so it does have, you know, you can watch my video where I poured Tabasco on it and it fell right off. Other than that, the shirt isn't stretchy at all, and it's not, I don't find that it breathes very well, and so it's like an okay shirt. But as you can see in this roundup, for the price, you can do a lot better. And last but absolutely not least is Woody's. The two dress shirts in my entire collection that have become my most worn shirts is the Mizzen & Main pink one that you saw earlier. I wear that on so many flights. It's my favorite dress shirt to travel in. And then also this Woody's shirt, because it has all the best parts of performance dress shirting while looking like an awesome dress shirt. So I wear this to executive meetings, office. I wear this to so many places, but it never wrinkles. It's antibacterial, so it's really good at repelling odor, stains, and smells. It comes in at $115, and it's fully customizable. So this has one of the best fits in my closet as well, because I can give them down to the quarter inch my exact neck size, sleeve size, waist, and you can also customize what sort of collar, cuff, pleat, and placket you want on the shirt. So I think if you're gonna go into this space and you're not gonna go to Mizzen & Main, go to Woody's, because if you get your custom fit with them, you can continuously order shirts over and over. The big thing with this is they don't have that many styles right now, but they're about to revamp their performance line and they're adding stain resistance as well into this, and I'm gonna cover that as soon as it comes out. The Woody's shirt also stands up best underneath like a blazer, and so when I wear a blazer to a meeting with this dress shirt, you're looking killer, and it requires so little like maintenance that it's really easy to just wash, hang dry, and that's what you do with all these shirts. Woo! So there you have it, gents. That is my performance dress shirt roundup. If I miss any brands, let me know down in the comments. You can also reach out at @_Kavalier on Twitter and Instagram. I'll be sure to include that in the website guide that I'm building out once I'm done with the sneaker roundup guide. I'm still working on both of those. But as always, I love your feedback and comments on these videos. It's what helps me to do videos like this because you guys recommend great things and ask great questions in the comments, which then feeds the beast. And then I really appreciate all the support and love. If you have any questions about the shirts, I'm happy to answer those. I wear them all the time. I'm untethered, as somebody had mentioned in the sneaker roundup. I'm untethered from any sponsorship, so I can say whatever I want about them, which is really nice and which is why I'm really glad you're supporting the channel. I'll quit rambling. Until next time, gents, this is the Kavalier.